Hi, this is Stuart with tallbridgeguy.com. Just going to do a quick Sketchup video. I'm going to start with a strip seal. A strip seal is an expansion joint for a bridge. Bridges with concrete typically expand and contract at the ends if they're a long bridge, and you need some way to account for the expansion at the end of a bridge. So we've got an expansion joint. And this is one typically used on bridges. And what I want to do is I want to draw this little steel shape. And if you look at the little steel shape, it looks like, you can see it here. And I have a picture of it right here. So I want to draw this in SketchUp. I don't have any other dimensions than what's given. So I'm going to just do a quick representation of it in SketchUp. So let's start it up. Picture of my dog, good dog. I guess I should have started it up, but let's say delete the person that comes in. Let's insert or import a JPEG, and I want to use it as an image. And I have it under 3D Fun. Put it right here. It doesn't really matter what size it is. There it is. I'm just going to rotate it to make it a little easier to work with. 90 degrees. And I'm not worried about the scale of it yet. So I'm going to change the camera to parallel projection. I can't even talk today. It's just been one of those days. And I'm going to go to my styles window. Right, styles, what your background, everything is looking like in your file. So let's go to edit and let's pick profiles. And let's make it 3 and let's make it a nice red color. And all I'm doing is my lines, my edges, I'm going to be able to see them because they're going to be red. All right, well, let's just start drawing. And you have to make sure that you draw, you're on the surface. Now, on face and image, that's exactly what I want. In 3D drawing programs, you may be out of luck if you don't get it right on the face. I don't know how far it's going to go over there. I'll just leave it. Join it down to here. If you need to zoom in a little bit, maybe get that little bit of chamfer. And this is just, again, a quick representation. Zoom out. Zoom in. Let's see here. I'm going to start there. Somewhere in there. Let's get this little middle part. So I think it starts about a straight line right about there. Right about there. And I can pick the arc. Kind of looks like it looks like that. Pick the arc. All right, I got to start on it. So what I can do is I can just move it over here. And now I can figure out the scale of it. Well, I know it's 2 inches tall, so how tall is my structure? 1 foot, 1 11/16, and me without a calculator. So what is that? Maybe 1/13, right? So my little brain, it's not working today. Accessories, calculator. All right, let's go back to this calculator. So what do I have? 2 divided by, what did I have, 13 inches approximately? All right, 0.153. All right, let's start with that. So let's select it. Change the scale to 0.153. Is that what I said I had? Yep. So let's go and look at it now. So if I were to measure it, what do I have? About 2 1/8. Not bad for now. So I can just copy this one over here. And I want to go over 1 1/4 inches. this one doesn't look very level, so I'm going to get rid of that one. And I'm just going to draw across. I guess it was level. I can cut off the corners. Now I have a face. Go to camera, para, perspective. And it's pretty close, I bet. I can extrude it. And I think this would be good enough. Let's select it all. I guess it'd be more rusty looking. But there it is, and I can change back my profiles to black. It's the edges. I can make them smaller again if you want to make it a little calmer. But there, quickly, is an extruded joint, or expansion joint. And you can work and put that in your bridge. And of course, you can get a better measurement if you take a few more minutes than I did. Or get a better calculator. All right, well, thanks for visiting.